Hello and welcome back to the ICU Doc. This is Gabriel Prada and here is a quick lecture about ultrasound basic concept where we'll explain the most relevant ultrasound imaging modalities. 2D imaging modality, also referred to as B-mode, shows us structures in two dimensions, that is depth and width, or vertical and horizontal axis. Structures closer to the probe will be closer to the top of the image, and a structure farther from the probe will be closer to the bottom of the image. In this 2D image, we have the inferior vena cava coming across the liver and into the right atrium. Here we see the inferior vena cava cut on its longitudinal axis. That is why we see it as a tube. 2D is a standard imaging modality in ultrasound because it gives us the entire anatomically logical picture of the structures we want to evaluate. M-mode, which stands for motion mode, was one of the first ultrasound modalities developed that allowed ultrasound to be successfully used in medicine. Take a first look at the M-mode recording of the respiratory variation of the inferior vena cava diameter. You see the M-mode recording in the bottom, and as a reference, the 2D image in the top. M-mode imaging includes a timescale, whereby reflected echoes displayed along a single line on the vertical axis are placed side by side on the horizontal axis. The vertical axis represents motion of the structures toward and away from the ultrasound probe, and the horizontal axis represents time. M-mode is ideal for the evaluation of motion and timing, especially for subtle or rapid movements. Let's see the M-mode recording again. With M-mode, we use a vector line that we can accommodate over the structure we want to evaluate. We can see how the inferior vena cava collapses as the patient takes a rapid sniff. And having that inferior vena cava diameter in one picture is very useful since we can easily measure and compare both diameters and its change over time. Here we show the use of M-mode for the subtle movement, long sliding, which is the physiologic sliding of the visceral pleura under the parietal pleura of the lung as the lung inflates and deflates during a normal respiratory cycle. The structures above the pleura line are the skin and soft tissue of the thoracic wall that appear as a collection of straight horizontal lines because they're not moving at all. In M-mode, structures that are not moving will appear as straight horizontal lines. Right below the pleura line, we have the visceral pleura and the lung showing a myriad of points creating this granular appearance as a result of the motion of the lung. More on these on lung ultrasound lectures. You don't want to miss that. Now let's finish with color Doppler modality. Because you already know about wave frequency, I think you're ready to be amazed by the incredible Doppler effect and its life-changing significance. The Doppler effect is described as the change in the frequency of a wave in relation to a structure that is moving relative to the source of the wave. In medicine, the moving structure is the blood, specifically the red blood cell, and the source of the wave is the ultrasound probe. So, when an ultrasound wave hits a red blood cell that is moving away from or towards the ultrasound probe, the wave changes its frequency. The ultrasound wave that is reflected back to the probe will then have a different wave frequency, and this difference in wave frequency will enable the machine to figure out whether the red blood cell was moving away from or towards the probe, and even the velocity of its movement. In other words, we can see blood flow. If the red blood cell is moving away from the probe, the reflected wave will have a lower frequency, whereas if the red blood cell is moving towards the probe, the reflected wave will have a higher frequency. In medical ultrasound, blood flow moving towards the probe will be seen as red, while the moving away from the probe will be seen as blue. In echocardiography, color Doppler modality allows us to evaluate valvular pathologies, especially regurgitation. In astrophysics and life in general, however, the Doppler effect forever changed our understanding of the cosmos. In 1925, Mr. Albert Einstein published the general theory of relativity. What then would become, in Einstein's own words, his biggest blunder, he couldn't believe that his equations predicted that the universe were to expand forever. He thought that it was impossible that our universe, with our planet Earth and all our ultrasound machines and patients, would expand inevitably and indefinitely, forever and ever. Einstein just did not believe his own work. What all of this nonsense has to do with color Doppler, Gabe, you might be asking. Well, Mr. Edwin Hubble, the guy on the right next to Einstein, a lawyer and basketball coach from Chicago who then decided to become an astronomer, discovered that light coming from galaxies that were farther from the Earth showed a lower wave frequency compared to those closer to the Earth. This, according to the Doppler effect, meant that galaxies farther from the Earth were moving away from the Earth faster than those closer to the Earth. And this, according to complicated mathematical models that I will never understand, was solid evidence to conclude that the universe is expanding, which was in line with the description of the Big Bang as the beginning of the universe, and ancient original predictions. In 1929, Mr. Edwin Hubble published his paper, and the rest is history. Now back to our expanding ultrasonic world. Here we have an apical four-chamber view, and we will evaluate blood flow across the mitral valve, that is, from the left atrium into the left ventricle. To use color Doppler, we first select the color Doppler control, usually termed as color, which then prompts a color box, which is the area of Doppler interrogation. We place the color box over the mitral valve and the inflow area of the left ventricle. As we can see, during diastole, the color box shows a red area that illustrates the blood coming towards the probe, that is, coming from the left atrium, across the mitral valve, and into the left ventricle. We do not see any big blue area crossing the mitral valve or entering the left atrium, indicating absence of mitral regurgitation. Here we compare, on the left, the same heart we saw on the previous slide, that, by the way, is my heart, with the heart on the right, which has severe mitral regurgitation. On the right, you can see how a whole jet of blue blood flow across the mitral valve, which, by being blue, means that it is moving away from the probe, that is, coming from the left ventricle into the left atrium. This is serious regurgitation. Thank you for watching. Make sure you check out our website and YouTube channel, and follow us on Twitter to stay updated when new videos come out. If you like the videos, make sure you like, subscribe, and share.